I'm Mark Hughes. Welcome to Disability Viewpoints. My very special guest host today is Nikki Villavicencio. We are remembering Rick Cardenas today, who just recently passed away in the Twin Cities. He was a big part of the disability community, and that's coming up on today's show. Nikki, some of your forethoughts of Rick Cardenas.
Rick Cardenas was a great mentor of mine, and I really appreciated learning all the things that I did from him. And, you know, we enjoyed getting a chance to discuss and tribute to him with my special guest, Darrell Paulsen, also disability rights activist.
Very good. And also Carrie Sheldon, the chairman of the Mayor's Committee for People with Disabilities, will join us on the show. So the whole half hour today is dedicated to Rick Cardenas. So we hope you'll join us next on Disability Viewpoints here on SPNN. So with me today is Mary Kay Kennedy from Advocating Change Together, Darrell Paulsen from Paulsen and Companies, and Carrie Sheldon from the Mayor's Committee for People with Disabilities in St. Paul. Welcome everyone to the show. And I think we'll start out with Mary Kay Kennedy because she was a business partner of Rick's for a long time at Advocating Change Together. It's a very difficult time right now. It is for me, although I can't show it on the air or we wouldn't get anything done today. Rick and I spent a lot of time, as everybody did, down at the Senate and House and State Capitol, and Rick worked very, very hard. And a lot of the, as Darrell said before we went on the air, a lot of the things that we learned or grew up with in those circles, we learned from Rick. He was kind of a forefather in what we all do every day. And so I want him to be remembered for that. And his identity thing at the cemeteries was another thing he worked on very, very hard. So Mary Kay, we can start with your first thoughts as you are a co-partner of Advocating Change Together. And I'll try to keep it together up here.
Well, you know, Mark, as you say, it's a sad time. And for sure, it's sad to see somebody we love so much go. But then at the same time, you know, Rick led such an interesting and full life, and he lived to be almost 80 years old. So when you think of him, you know, just like when he first was injured, they were saying, you know, you are not going to live a long life. So I think that he, you know, part of his journey in life was just every day was a gift. And he really, he did a lot. He enjoyed life. He loved people. He had his own house. He had transportation. He had people who loved him. So he really lived a great life. So there's a part of me, you know, of course, like everyone else, I'm sad to see him go and I miss him terribly. But there's another part that thinks, oh my gosh, what a reason to celebrate that he got to be on this planet and he was part of all of our lives.
Yeah, just think of the experience and the marks he left on our lives. In a good way, I mean that. He was a teacher, and I don't know if we all knew that he was teaching us while he was talking to us, and he was like no other
example how to be out there enjoying life side by side with everyone else, and just by being present and being active in the community, that was his leadership. That was just leading by example,
right?
In much the same way that the three of you do as well. So I don't look at Rick and think like, oh, he was, you know, I have great affection for him, but I think all of you carry those same qualities that you're leading and making a difference in the world.
We had it instilled in us. I learned everything I know from Darrell Paulsen. I know that.
Well, thank you, Mark. And I learned a lot from you as well. And I did learn so much from Rick. And the one thing I can tell you is, Rick and Mary Kay, both of you have given Nikki and I a huge opportunity to be self-advocates and to be leaders in our community. And the reason I say that is because, Mary Kay, I don't know if you remember this, but Rick and you gave Nikki and I opportunity to work for you guys. Shortly, right after you guys we were getting ready to sign the contract. Rick was the first person that we told that Nikki was pregnant. So Allie, my daughter, who calls Rick Grandpa Rick, okay, she very much means that when she says that. And the fact that when I met with Rick, I told him we had something really, really exciting to tell him. And, so we met down at one of his favorite spots. I think it was the Taco House right across from Boca Chica's there in St. Paul. And he says, okay, what do you got to tell me? And they says, well, I'll have Nikki tell you, but you're gonna be a grandpa. Oh. And he's like, oh, shoot. But he didn't say shoot. He actually probably swore a little bit.
Yeah. We can't use that word on here, Darrell, but yeah. I know which one you meant. Yeah.
So he says, oh, shoot. Now you're not going to be able to work for me. So now what do we do? And I'm like, don't worry, Rick. We'll bring the baby in tow. We'll bring the baby wherever we need to bring the baby. And that was a direct result of changing some of the light rail cars along the green line, along the LRT and the central corridor. That was a direct result of Work's teaching us and leadership and skills that he taught us how to do that. And to this very day, I serve on those committees to this day because of the things that Rick's taught me.
Well, so, and I'll tell you one other story.
Go ahead.
I think that behind the scenes in the legislature, the House, and the Senate, Rick Cardenas had all those folks who were running that the utmost in respect and got a lot more done with passing of his bills for he and Mary Kay and advocating change together in a hurry than most of us could ever done. I think he had more respect with the politicians than anybody. He just knew how to talk to anybody at any level. And I sat back and I was amazed, how'd he do that? How'd he say that? Because he's not going to show you again. It was one time only. But it was very good. And like I just say, he had all the respect of everybody. And so he could come through and get more bills passed and a lot of things done for the disabled. Right. Yeah. So we had a gift of gold and we didn't know it a lot of times.
Absolutely. And I know if Nikki was here, she would say she would not be the leader and she would not be the elected official today without Rick. If it wasn't for Rick, Rick helped her in her campaign tremendously. Rick was her campaign manager in the first campaign, and he went on to advise her in the second campaign all the way up until the election. So yeah. We would not have elected officials sitting at the table representing us without the great works that Rick installed in all of us.
Right. And with me today is Carrie Sheldon. She is chair of the Mayor's Committee for People with Disabilities in St. Paul. She also knew Rick Cardenas pretty well, so we'll let her talk about her memories right now.
Thanks, Mark, for inviting me to pay tribute to Rick Cardenas. I knew him. We worked a lot on the light rail, making sure that people were able to get to and from the light rail and get on and off the light rail, accessibility wise, and it just was a lot of fun to work with him, and making sure that even the that people were able to get to and from work using the elevator.
Right.
That was a really big issue with that.
The Cardenas connection. We can always talk about that, and I think somebody should actually put that through to the legislature. I know Dave, Representative Pinto, does want to do that at some point. And what I mean by that is that elevator that connects the Skyway to the central corridor or the central station, that elevator had gotten taken out of legislative priority status.
Yeah, I remember.
And it
that.
Had gotten removed out of legislative process three times. Mm-hmm. Each time, Rick had to install a couple of us, himself, and a few other folks to go back to the legislature and say, we need to put this back in. They took it out three times. The third time they put it back in and said, we should call this the Cardenas Connection.
Yeah.
And that's absolutely true.
Well, yeah. I didn't want to misunderstand you, because I always known the Cardenas Connection, because he always had somebody, if he wanted something done, he always knew who to call or who to ask to get it.
That's right.
Hey, I need this done. Let's get this done now, you know.
Yep.
And that was my idea of the Cardenas Connection. But I'm glad you clarified that, Darrell.
Yeah, thank you.
Mary Kay, as far as organizational with Advocating Change Together, it took a lot to put that together. The unmarked name stones in the cemetery were a big issue with Rick, and a lot of other things. What can you tell us about his career at Advocating Change Together?
Yeah, so he started with Advocating Change Together back in 1996. So the Remembering with Dignity project was just a couple of years old at that time. And that was a project where one of our members, had come forward and said, you know, that we're concerned that all of these unmarked graves. So we began the process of approaching the legislature and getting money to actually mark those graves. So that was a big effort and campaign for Advocating Change Together. And I think Rick was just good at helping people understand that that project really was not so much about marking the graves, but using that as a vehicle to really help people understand what the history of people with disabilities has been in our state, and help people understand just kind of how much our society missed by institutionalizing people. Mm-hmm. So the focus of the project really was on celebrating the lives of people with disabilities and honoring their lives in the community. And I think Rick was really a good spokesperson for that. He loved going on radio and TV and talking about it. And he just did a great job just helping communicate that it's really not about, it's about so much more than the graves. And then the other issue that came up during that time is we were working with, because the leadership of that project really was folks with intellectual and developmental disabilities. Mm-hmm. So the people that either maybe had been institutionalized or would be at risk of being institutionalized.
Right.
One of the fellas that had lived at Faribault State Hospital for many years said, you know, I lived there for all those years, and he told the stories about it, and he said, and nobody ever said I'm sorry. Nobody ever said I'm sorry for what happened to me. And so then we thought, you know, that's right. So then we decided to go to the legislature and ask for a formal and public apology for the wrongful institutionalization of people with disabilities. And that took probably a decade to get through. And in one sense, in terms of when you think of it from an organizing perspective, the resistance that the legislature had to actually apologizing worked as another wonderful vehicle for us to get the word out and keep that issue going around just increasing awareness of the lives of people with disabilities and their history.
Yes, absolutely, Mary Kay. That's a beautiful story. I remember that night when some of the advocates shared their story. We were over at Black Bear Crossing. Mm-hmm. I believe Representative Karen Clark came out that night.
Yeah.
They made a...
John Marty. So Karen and Clark and John Marty, just wonderful, wonderful leaders and connectors with the disability community. So, and they did just a heartfelt apology from the state directly to people with intellectual disabilities. And I remember there were a number of people there that night that had been institutionalized, and that meant a lot. That really was a huge deal that they were getting that apology.
You know, they'll tell you down at the state, if you're gonna start a bill today, it might be passed 10 years from now. So they tell you, that's how slow the government can work. But I remember that night, and the apology was well deserved because Rick worked very hard at that. And Rick didn't always take no for an answer. I admired him for that.
Yep.
You know, if he went in one way but it didn't work, he came through another way. And that was his creative thinking. And he was just a great guy all the way around and did a lot. And I think we have a lot to be thankful for.
Yep.
And one of the things I think Rick would be uncomfortable with in some of these conversations about all the things that he did is I think Rick really did have an understanding that no individual really does anything on their own.
Nope.
So we always talked about at ACT, it's not about me, it's about we.
We, yep.
Mm-hmm. It's part of a big we and part of a big community that the four of us are all, you know, still included in.
Yeah.
And he was just part of that. So he didn't get the apology passed. He didn't mark those graves.
Right. We did it together.
We all did it together and just celebrated together as a community.
Yep, and that was, Rick very much embodied that in everything he did and everything he celebrated. It was, you're right, it wasn't about him and what he did, it was about what we did together as a community, what we're going to do together, and what we still have to do together. You know, and that's the thing that, every, you know, when Rick was able to, he would call me up at different times of the night and you'd say, are you watching this? Are you gonna advocate for this? I'd be like, no. And they'd be like, why not? I'd be like, because I know you're gonna do it, Rick. You know, I can do something else. You'd be like, oh, yeah. Well then how about I do this, you do this. And then we started to tag team off with some things, and we were able to influence the anti-bullying legislation, and we were able to put some of our issues and our concerns into some anti-bullying policies that were created, particularly in Anoka County. I mean, I remember some of those conversations, and I know Rick did many things outside of his normal everyday scope of business work that he did. Mm-hmm. So some of the things he did, even in his personal time and his time off, but I know some of the things he liked to do. He liked to go fishing. He did a lot of fishing and a lot of eating chicken. I mean, I think we ate chicken almost at every event, but that was fine too. It's a pleasure. I will never be able to measure up to the work that he's done, but if I can at least get and measure up to a quarter of what he's done, then what he's taught me was well worth every dollar that he and you spent on us and my family. So thank you for that too, Mary Kay.
Well, Mary Kay, I do think that I agree with Darrell. We should put forth a bill for the Cardenas connection.
I agree.
And we never let Rick look at the vacation calendar too long, because every time he came by me, he said, Mark, take care of this for me, will you? Okay, Rick, I'm right on it, you know. So, I mean, he, and that's the first lesson you got to learn in management is you delegate the responsibility.
Yep.
And
mm-hmm.
He just knew what he was going to do when, and I think we'll miss that. And like I've said before, and I'll repeat it again, he had the respect of all the legislatures there. There wasn't anybody that didn't know him, didn't say a bad word about him. They just listened to him, and most of the time he came out the winner. And that's mm-hmm. what was important there.
And the Senate actually is bringing forward a Rick Cardenas resolution. So that'll be on the Senate floor. And then we're having a celebration of Rick's life in July. And then I think Senator Hoffman and Senator Abler will be able to read that resolution at his ceremony.
Yep.
So I just probably just mention an outdoor service is planned from 1 to 5 p.m. June 13th at Harriet Island.
Okay.
So I think that'll really be a great celebration of his life.
Right.
Jerry, Carrie, were you the big chairman now in St. Paul?
Yes.
Can you go to the city and see what can be done for Rick?
I will. At our next meeting, I will be bringing that up for discussion, to do a resolution.
Yeah, that'd be a great honor. Mm-hmm. Do you have any more memories of Rick that you want to talk about?
I didn't really work all too much with Rick. I just did a few things as far as going and participating in the events for the grave markers, and I also did participate in the surveying of the light rail.
Right.
Yep. Carrie, I remember many times we would have meetings in your building organized by Rick and myself, and you would be there, and you organized many of the residents to come down and speak to us.
Yep.
And advocate with us. I mean, you don't give yourself enough credit at times.
I know.
Because you're always busy doing something.
Yeah, Carrie, you were on the team. We worked you too. You were there. Mm-hmm.
Yep. And I guess I just want to add to that, Darrell, because I know Carrie, so many community events, the Remembering with Dignity and different things at the Capitol, and just, you know, over all the decades. And I always remember, like, you and Rick really gravitated towards each other.
Yeah,
so
we did.
I thought he'd be like, you always had something to say or some connection to say to each other. Yeah. So I always, you know, saw you two talking. I didn't really know what you were talking about.
I certainly will miss him, you know, going through the sky or even on the street. You know, it's not going to be the same.
You know, the big thing that I think that Rick represents are, you know, nothing about us without us, for sure. And, you know, the thing that, I don't know how much Darrell shared with you.
Oh, Darrell did a great job. He was a great fill-in for you.
You know that.
You know, he's not as cute as you are, but he did a great job.
Love that one.
Okay. Well, I was so proud that Rick Cardenas was our first friend that we told that we were having our daughter to. And so that was super exciting. And, you know, the thing that I learned a lot about him is to be involved in electoral politics. So as many of you know, I ran for city council, and Rick is my campaign manager.
And you won.
And let me tell you, I could not have done it without him. He taught me to be like a bulldog and not take no for an answer. And
that would be right.
You know, he taught me that we don't silence marginalized people. We uplift the folks in our community of the most marginalized, because the government works for disabled people in our lives every day. Mm-hmm. And who should run it but people with disabilities like Rick Cardenas? And, you know, he ran for office. So I literally sit on the shoulders of Rick Cardenas. And, you know, the teachings he had from working with Paul Wellstone about organizing, and the spiral method. Remember, Mary Kay, we always did the spiral method together. I could never think about organizing without Rick Cardenas.
Okay.
And the amazing things. And, you know, whenever somebody would say, you know, the work that you guys do is amazing, it's so amazing, he'd say, good, send money.
Good, there you go.
And so, why did you do that, Nikki? What was that about? It was not about the fact that he didn't think you were amazing, but why did he do that? Why do you think he did that?
Well, because he felt that what we did every day wasn't really amazing. It was the work that we did every day to make all of our lives better,
not just
the quote unquote amazing people. And so he felt that if you thought that what we're doing is a good thing, then you should contribute to it.
Absolutely.
In any way you can.
Yeah, don't just talk about it, send money, right?
Right.
So anyway, let's begin the final word segment now very quickly. Mary Kay, we want you to go first. You worked with him, and we're a big part of his corporate life and personal life too, so.
Yeah, so I heard you say, Mark, and I think Darrell, you mentioned that, like, he would work kind of even on his time off, he would be doing stuff with disability rights. But Rick really didn't have his life compartmentalized like that. So his life was just his life. And he, home and work were completely intersecting. Yeah. So it didn't surprise me at all, Darrell, when you were kind of telling the story of saying, yeah, we're having a baby, that he's like, yeah, good, bring the kid along. So he really did that in his life. So when Rick started working with ACT, his nephews were young grade school boys, and his sister, and everybody came with. So we didn't just get Rick, but we got the whole family.
The whole family, yeah.
The whole family got us. So I don't know if you can see this picture, but this is one of my favorite pictures. Aww. Of Rick. He loved kids.
Yeah.
And every time Rick went to Mexico or anywhere he went, when he came back, he had presents for the kids. He had dresses and flowers and puppets. And he really, I think, saw his family as being part of our families being part of his, and our whole big, beautiful disability community being a family.
Very well said. Thank you, Mary Kay. Darrell, let's have you go next.
Well, nobody's mentioned this yet, and I don't know how much we want to mention it, but I don't know if anybody remembers the last part of Rick's story before Rick went on to heaven to meet my mom and to hang out and do great fishing expeditions that he's doing today. But Rick found out he was a father just before he passed away, and he got to meet his son.
Yeah, I read about that.
That was a beautiful story. And I mean, I hope what I learned from that is that when Rick would engage with me and my family, he was embodying that, being able to be a family man and being able to be that connector to families. So when he met his son, and they wanted to meet again over Zoom at some point, or even in person, he didn't get the opportunity to do that. So I hope to be able to, at some time, be able to foster that relationship, or to meet a son and continue that relationship for Rick and with him.
I mean, great, very well said. Carrie Sheldon, one more thought before we go.
It's just going to be really hard not to see him at the Capitol or rolling down the street or in the skyway if we ever are going to get through this pandemic. It's just going to be really difficult not to be able to work on accessibility issues.
Right. And Nikki, one more thought before we go.
Just rest in power, Rick Cardenas. You know, I'll always remember nothing about us without us.
Very good. And thanks for watching Disability Viewpoints. I'm Mark Hughes for Nikki Villavicencio and the whole entire team. Again, rest in peace, Rick Cardenas. We'll see you soon on Disability Viewpoints. Bye for now.